guys, welcome back. We're doing Sealfra River Well Depths, part 2. Just been working my way around the left edge of Sealfra. And here we're up to the little wooden hut and structure. Spectral guardians. He's coming down. Let's give him a punch. Didn't realize you could punch people on stairs. There you go. They can kick and you can punch. Makes sense, I guess. Bit of loot's at the top here. Sliver of meat. And cook herself a steak later on. A steak for dinner. Crabby. Some more crab eggs. There's another podium there you can light up. Lily. As I said before, I haven't been lighting these all up on the way through this time, so I have to go back and do that later. So make sure you light all these up as you go along, and once you light them all up, the boss gets unlocked. Don't hate on me for killing the cute deers. They are dropping the thin beast bones. You can use them to craft a lot of different bolts and arrows. I'm doing their war stomp. Some loot down there that I missed. Golden rune 4. So still following the left edge. Okay, there's a beetle ball at the top there. Drop Dash of War, square off. Giant filthy rats. War Stompers. I can see a golden seed. Very nice. Rolling sheep. I think they just do it for fun. Must be very bored out here. This edge goes around a bit. Cave. Runak. Nope, it's a real wall. Seemed like he could open it up. Looks very precarious down there. Red ball, don't care about that one. Okay, there's a bowman around here somewhere. There he is, up on the hilltop. Let's go and take him out. Okay, got a big staircase at the back here. Clarifying Horn Charm. This is a talisman that will raise your focus. And an elevator with a stone sword key lock. I don't know why I did that. I thought something might happen. Okay, I might leave that for a bit later. Let's just finish off this area first. Formic rocks. This can be used to craft acid spray mist, which releases acid mist from the mouth. Okay, going down the eastern side. There is a beacon there to light up. It's just a red ball. There's a portal there. Might follow that a bit later. I'll work my way down the eastern side first. Okay, let's pick up the side of grass. Great horned headband. Okay, nice. Melted mushrooms. Smithing stone too. And trainer's lily. Dwelling arrows. And we have a bowman up high. I'll have to get up there and get him. There's another beacon right there that you can light up. Out the bowman. And there is another portal here. We will go through a bit later. Just really want to finish this area off first. Somber smithing stone too. Deppled cured meat. More mushies. Another beacon to light up. Three more over here. Killing them on horseback's obviously much easier. Jawbone axe. Okay, there's a spirit jump here. Let's give it a go. That's not good. See ya. Let's try again. I'll grab my runes. Let's be a bit more careful this time. Okay. That is a long way down. So I think we can go down a little bit. Some steps down there. A mistake. Let's give it a try. Oh, nearly fell off. Okay, there's nothing there. Side, except for a big drop. And we got some dwelling arrows, 10 of them. That was really worthwhile. Spectral Guardians. Alright, what's he got? Golden Rune for. There is something down there I can see. And a horn bow. Coming back to the staircase where the boss is. There's a map there, that's nice. Gives us a map of the whole area. Okay, so as you can see, the boss is not active right now, so I need to go back and activate all of those beacons, but if you've done that, he'll be active and you can go in. It's going to do a level up before we finish, and I'll cover off the boss in the next episode. Let's go for endurance. Okay guys, thanks for watching, we'll see you next time, bye for now.